What's up, Star Crew? It's Super Barbie Star Mom here. I'm gonna show you a video or a conglomeration of videos that we took on a trip a couple weeks ago. Ohio, and supposedly it has like some of the record-breaking roller coasters roller coasters in the world, and I will tell you that yes, they do. I don't know, because I mean Kings Island, the Vortex used to be, I mean, that was my scary roller coaster. So and that's weak compared to the roller coisters they have today. These, what are they called, Hybra or something? I don't know. I was dangling off the edge of the earth. That's all I know. I mean, literally, I thought I was dying, for sure. They have several roller coasters there. Like, most of the roller coasters there are, the hills are 90 degree. Like, they're perpendicular to the ground. And they're like 100 feet drops. Insanity! My kid made me ride them because we had my daughter and her friend, who is my best friend's daughter, and then my son, who needed a partner to ride with, and so I was the lucky one, and I thought I was gonna die, and I didn't die. So but if you are a person that likes to be scared out of your mind, you should go to Cedar Point and ride their roller coasters. Another thing, though, and this was a complaint, this is just me doing a little review on Cedar Point. They had this Halloween thing going on, and so we went at night, and it was on a Friday night. I don't even think they opened until like 5 or 6, but it was dark, and they didn't light things. Like, you would think if it's going to be dark that they would have, like, you know, like the sidewalk or the side walkways or whatever lit. We didn't know where we were going half the time. Like, we spent more time turned around and trying to figure out where the crap we were going than it was annoying. So, and then at one point, I had to go to the bathroom, and we were looking for a bathroom. I'm like, how far can, I mean, seriously, like, there's got to be a restroom here. I couldn't find any, there's no workers anywhere to help you either. The only workers that they had were zombie people walking around, jumping out and scaring you, which made me pee my pants almost 4 times. So, I was just kidding. Anyhow, the zombie people, they scared the bejesus out of us, but they couldn't tell us where the bathroom was. So, the person that told us where the bathroom was a football coach, or a baseball coach, local, that his kids were there cleaning the bathrooms. We were like, huh? You're not a worker, you're a baseball coach, and your team is here cleaning the bathroom. But where's workers? I don't know. I didn't get that. We weren't in love with that whole setup. But roller coasters, yes. Okay, so there's that situation. And I wanted to do an update on Twin Flame situation, because the whole concept of the same collective community, The concept keeps changing, because we are polar opposites. When I discovered what a twin flame was, I knew that I was one, and I knew who my twin flame was. And I still think, without a doubt, like, know from every fiber in me that he is my twin flame. Reuniting. The whole twin flame community is supposed to be in a generation of reuniting. Well, that hasn't happened. And I felt like it was going to happen at one point, and I don't feel like that. The stuff, because we're limited by our own anymore. I don't feel him like I did before, like energetically. And, you know, how can that be possible? They said that you have to reunite, or else you can't ascend to the next level of or dimension. And if you don't reunite, then you have to come back to another life. That's not the glasses I wanted. That doesn't match. Where's the glasses I wanted? There we go. The collective is saying now that I don't think he's coming back. Oh, I know what I'm saying. The collective is saying now that the twin flame doesn't have to be your twin flame, that your vibrations can change and someone else can become your twin flame. So if you're going through this and you have a twin flame and you know more about this and you can clarify, holla at me. If you are in the twin flame thing and you're right where I am, like where you were right there on the cusp of reuniting and then boom, like they just backed off or you pushed them or something happened and it ain't happening, let me know, because apparently that's a whole lot of people are experiencing that, and I think it's bull. So twin flame stuff, yeah, there's that. I mean, the only good thing about him backing off and me not having my hopes up anymore is that I can find me a Prince Charming now. So I got all kinds of stuff, but I'm not working still, and I'm on a leave, and that situation is essentially what it's been for the past 3 years of my life in education, and that is, it's just basically, I'm going to sum it up by saying workplace bullying. That's what it is. I am the target of a bunch of bullies. And when I switch schools, they contact the administration from the administrators and they fill them in on, you know, what a horrible person I am or whatever it is they say about me. And then they bully me. They're on me. They want me gone. They I don't know. I don't get it. But might be the men in black behind all this. I'm just kidding a little bit. So that's why I'm off, and I don't know what I'm gonna do with my life, but I'll let you know, okay? Because it's gonna be good, whatever it is. I'm working on my vibrations. That's what I'm doing. I'm tuning myself to higher vibrations so that I can have more abundance. Peace out and have a beautiful day.
I'm recording this because I took pictures, but I don't know if it's good. These clouds look like cartoon.
Look over there. What are these clouds?
They're not 3D. They're more than 3D. They're. I can't explain it. There's not words. There are no words. No words.
And like nobody else is even acting
like this. Are we? What? The clouds look. Look at that freaking cloud! You can't tell me that's normal.
No.
That is like.
Everywhere. I mean, I'm.
I mean.
I almost feel like we should just pull over and lay down. Look at
that! Oh, no. We got time!
Oh, God.
My goodness!
Yes, we do have time.
What in the world?
But look up there. Like, look at the over. Like, that to me just.
That cloud right there.
This one.
All of those. All yeah. Those right there are like.
Oh, my gosh! That one looks like a little cloud you, like, can make out of dots. Like, look, see it.
That one looks like Falcor. Falcor! Sebastian! No, what's it called?
Never Ending Story.
No, but what's the land called? I can't remember what land the...
Now I want to watch that movie.
Oh, the nothingness is taking over.
Yeah.
The nothingness is taking over.
Have you ever seen the Never Ending Story, guys?
We gotta show Sebastian because I named him after the kid. The main kid in Sebastian. I mean, in Never Ending Story, his name is Sebastian. He's like the hero. He's the hero that saves the world from the nothingness. That is swallowing up everything.
Guys, look. Like,
this is not. This view on the camera.
Up in the sky.
What?
Oh
my gosh. Look over there.
What?
I saw two alligators. They look like real alligators.
Oh my goodness, that's what Falcor looks like. It's a furry alligator.
Me and my
mom.
Oh.
No, eyes and everything.
Eyes? Wow. What? I did too. I just got a hang on. hope I don't have a heart attack.
Roller coaster. Why do they put those cones in there?
I love the, what?
Did they even give you air time in this fucking car right now?
Oh, right here? Yeah, so nobody has a head-on collision. I don't know. Taking our hot kids to Cedar Point.
I'm sexy. I'm sexy and I know.
You are not sexy. Don't even use that word in a sentence describing
I'm
yourself.
Sexy.
I'm sexy. I don't know if I'm supposed to be
you're
friend
not,
or girlfriend.
And then there's two little, look at those little boys back there.
Yeah, sexy.
So we're at Cedar Point.
Oh, gatekeeper. I just saw gatekeeper.
Go. And if you want to take a look, there's a roller coaster over there that doesn't look like a roller coaster. It looks like like a roller coaster. It looks like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich folded.
It goes straight up and straight
over there, Dakota. See the little peanut.
What's that one's name?
Lucy. Lionel.
Ooh, look at a dead dude.
Weird dude. Yeah, he does look dead.
Oh my God, there's an old dude with the shovel.
Where?
Look, and then there's a mummy coming out of the ground.
Oh, there's dead. There's what did it say? There's gonna be ghosts and
the ghosts and clowns will be roaming.
It says clowns and ghosts
will be roaming the midways of America's roller coasters.
Okay, so we will check back in and tell you how we're doing.
Tell me, go straight. Okay.
There's the one. See that the tallest one there? That is a roller coaster, folks. That is the hill.
The Ferris wheel.
Straight up. And straight down.
Straight up
and straight down.
Like, you're going to see that Ferris wheel?
Like, figuratively and literally.
There. Mom, you're not going to wait there going up. It takes you straight up. You go shoot up.
Yeah.
I mean, is that the start of the ride?
I think there's a POV on it.
Or do you get some momentum first?
No, that's the start
of the ride. No, it goes straight up and straight down.
Oh, my gosh. I might not survive that one.
But I don't know if it, like, jostles you around.
I wonder if I should just pull up right here.
North side, shoddy with the west side. Blue coast. Streak. That's a wooden one. The blue wooden one. It's actually blue.
The clouds are still kind of weird. Not as weird as they were.
Y'all
want to
just park here?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's park here.
Raptor.
And I felt like we.
Cedar Point.
Think about that. Gatekeeper?
Okay, this is so
gatekeeper?
Cool.
Yes.
Now we're going to Gatekeeper. The Raptor was the scariest roller coaster I've ever been on in my life.
Wow. Really?
What do you guys rate the Raptor?
A 9 out of 10. 9 out of 10.
I rate it 11 out of 10.
That was so much fun. That was so much fun.
Okay, so now what are we doing now?
I think we're gonna do the gatekeeper. We're gonna do the gatekeeper?
Yes. I guess we're gonna do the gatekeeper now, so we will stay tuned. I'm kinda scared. I want my mommy. Definitely almost died that time. The hill was perpendicular to the ground. Looking at the pictures of our faces going down that perpendicular hill, And I was drawn to a picture of a girl in a hot pink or
like a coral
hoodie, and she had the blonde streak in her hair, and it was Lee. It was Peep. She was real tan, had the blonde streak, and I was like, that's Peepers, because we put on her perfume before we walked in here, and we were like, she's with us. I didn't know this, but that pic, the whoever that was, that Peepers was manifesting through, was right in front of me. And I didn't even see me. I didn't know that was right in front of me. So I just cried a little bit. So, okay, that's all I got. Bye. See you in a minute.
Oh my God.
Cold as balls too, see? And come here, bub. They, we'll get back with you when we get in the car. This is just doing too much.
Oh, interesting song for Carousel Ride.
Say cheese!